For My People by Margaret Walker. For my people, everywhere, singing their slave songs repeatedly, their dirges and their ditties, and their blues and their jubilees, praying their prayers nightly to an unknown God, bending their knees humbly. For my people, lending their strength to the years, to the gone years, and the now years, and the maybe years, washing, ironing, cooking and scrubbing, sewing, mending, hoeing, plowing, digging, planting, pruning, patching, dragging along, never gaining, never reaping, never knowing, and never understanding. For my playmates in the clay and dust and sand of Alabama backyards, playing baptizing and preaching and doctor and jail and soldier and school and mama and cooking and playhouse and concert and store and hair and Miss Chumbi and company. For the cramped, bewildered years, we went to school to learn, to know the reasons why and the answers to and the people who and the places where and the days when. In memory of the bitter hours when we discovered we were black and poor and small and different and nobody cared, nobody wondered, and nobody understood. Boys and girls who grew in spite of these things to be man and woman, to laugh, dance, and sing and play and drink their wine and religion and success, to marry their playmates and bear children and then die of consumption, anemia, and lynching. For my people, thronging 47th Street in Chicago and Lenox Avenue in New York and Rampart Street in New Orleans, lost, disinherited, dispossessed, and happy people filling the cabarets and taverns and other people's pockets, needing bread and shoes and milk and land and money and something.
Don't you take your time.
For my people, walking blindly, spreading joy, losing time, being lazy, sleeping when hungry, shouting when burdened, drinking when hopeless, tied and shackled and tangled amongst ourselves by the unseen creatures who tower over us omnisciently and laugh. For my people, blundering and groping and floundering in the dark of churches and schools and clubs and societies, associations and councils and committees and conventions, distressed and disturbed and deceived and devoured by money-hungry, glory-craving leeches, preyed on by facile force of state and fad and novelty by false prophets. For my people, standing, staring, trying to fashion a better way from confusion, from hypocrisy and misunderstanding, trying to fashion a world that will hold all the people, all the faith, all the Adams and the Eve and their countless generations. Let a new earth rise. Let another world be born. Let a bloody peace be written in the sky. Let a second generation full of courage issue forth. Let a people loving freedom come to growth. Let a beauty full of healing and a strength of final clinching be the pulsing in our spirit and our blood. Let the martial songs be written. Let the dirges disappear. Let a race of men now rise and take control.